Alright, and welcome back to Game Logger. My name is Revixy, and I'm back with the last episode of Batman, the Telltale series. The reason I'm a little bit delayed on this is both because of the New Year and Christmas and everything, but also because that the last episode just didn't save the actions I had done in the last four episodes at all. So I had to replay the game twice, the entire game, all four episodes. Twice, and it still didn't save the actions I had done in episode 5. So I don't know what the fuck was wrong with it then, but hopefully now it has actually saved it. So if it hasn't saved it now and it forces me to play through the entire game yet again, you guys just won't ever see the last episode, because quite frankly I had to play through the last episode all the way through to be able to start all over, or at least, you know, try and do that, right? The thing is, you can't just restart the episode to test anything. The second you have played an episode or started an episode, you started the last checkpoint or whatever, you can't start over the second you have. So it's kind of dumb built like that. So if you've completed the last episode, you have to restart the entire game. If I tried to go back to the episode before that, like the fourth episode, to start from that, it had not saved the choices from the three episodes behind that, and then it just repeat the same fucking problem from episode 3 to 2 to 1. So I had to start all the way from the very beginning, both times. So that is why. So without any more rambling, let's see if it had fixed itself, and yeah, let's get through this.
Breaking news. The children of Arkham have taken hostages. High-profile Gotham citizens, including Police Commissioner Peter Grogan, who was taken while attempting to intervene. I repeat, the children of Arkham have taken hostages.
Carry on, gents.
Boss says it's time to get the bat's attention. Batman's sighted, boss.
Right on top.
Apologies.
Commissioner, get to safety.
I can't just leave these people.
Unbelievable, my throat is killing me all of a sudden.
Not now. City.
Commissioner! Commissioner! He's gone.
Alfred.
Oh, thank God. With the comms offline, I've no idea what's happening out there. I always fear the worst.
I need to get back to the Batcave. Figure out Penguin's next move. I can't let him keep hurting innocent... Penguin improved the armor.
Batman! Impressive as ever! Life off the grid must be treating you well, huh?
What's your point?
My point is, you're at the end of your rope. You can't even stop me offing a police commissioner. Without your toys, you're nothing. Just turn yourself over to my men. Scouts on them, they'll go easy on you.
I think you're scared. Come out and face me, man to man.
Now why would I do that? When I can have this drone do all the work for me. Ta-ta, Batman! No, come on, just stay put.
Nope. Not gonna happen. Last time I actually said I don't need my choice, but...
Oh,
whatever. Fuck's sake.
If I can just find a way to hack into it, I can get to Penguin.
I apologize in advance for any fireworks or whatever.
Trap.
One of his men used a device that targeted my armor. If Penguin has more devices like that...
The Batsuit will be a liability.
It's already in bad shape. It couldn't protect me from a knife, let alone Penguin's new arsenal. If Batman can't take the fight to Penguin, maybe Bruce Wayne can.
Face Penguin as Bruce. Without your armor, you'll be more vulnerable.
Penguin wants hostages to bait Batman. Bruce Wayne will be the perfect hostage.
You can get close and strike when he least expects it.
Besides, I won't be going alone. Get Gordon on the line. Give him our files on Oswald Cobblepot. Tell him that we did a little digging after he took my position as CEO. He should know who really killed Commissioner Grogan. And that the killer will be in Cobblepot Park. Tell him that Bruce Wayne will meet him there. Lieutenant, these officers are at risk. Penguin is-
Wayne, get back!
I saw some kind of transmitter hidden behind the statue.
Give us room.
A transmitter?
Wayne Tech.
Controlling the drones.
God damn it! Some of my officers are still in there. I'm not gonna let some two-bit thief kill my men!
If you can destroy the transmitter, Oswald loses control of the drones.
There's no way to get to it, you heard Martinez.
Lieutenant, you need a distraction. I can keep him talking while you get into position.
How the hell are you gonna do that? I don't think listening to the guy who publicly attacked him is at the top of his priority list.
I know exactly how to push Oz's buttons. I'll make him so mad, the only thing he'll see is red.
That's all well and good, but he wants you dead.
Trust me, Lieutenant. I'm your best shot at getting those officers out alive.
This is insane. But I'm all out of options. I'll go in around the back. If he sees me...
He won't. I'll keep him focused on me. You will get your chance.
Keep the perimeter tight. If he suspects anything before those drones are offline, we're both dead.
Same device that fried the suit. It's a hell of a trap, Oz.
Sorry if I'm not saying much. As I said, I've played this part like twice, so. This is like the third time, so. The game is good on everything, but replaying it that many times is not really that good, so.
I hate them, Bruce! I really, really hate them!
Just because the goddamn game is broken.
My mom! Because she's in Arkham!
Those bullies aren't coming back.
They better not! Oh! Oh! They say bad things about my family! I'll smash the dumb faces!
Stop us, please!
I'll smash all the dumb faces!
Get the word out, eh? All the channels. The Penguin's got a Wayne in Cobblepot Park.
Oswald!
Bruce! Welcome! The pigs are making it hard to bring in the bait for Batman. But now that you're here, I have the perfect lure! Not that I'm upset, but... what does bring you by? Never known a Wayne to stick his neck out. Feels too good to be true.
I'm here to stop you from destroying Gotham.
You? Stop me? I'm the Liberator, not the Destroyer. You're the one who's corrupt and criminally insane. Still, I'm chuffed you popped by. Now, so far, only Gotham's finest have bothered to show. They paid for sticking their snouts in where they don't belong. You know, I'm surprised Batman's not already here to save you. He's usually so on top of everything. Maybe I need to cause a few more screams.
Maybe he's closer than you think. Just waiting for his moment to strike.
Oh, we'd know if he was. I've arranged quite the sounding light show for his arrival.
Already? Nice.
And when he arrives, oh ho ho! The lights, the sounds, the blood running into the gutters. Once he's out of picture, there'll be nothing left in our way. Mine, or Lady Arkham's. She's got some pretty big ideas for the city, and they're about to kick into gear.
I know Lady Arkham's real name. She's Vicky Vale.
Oh, did you figure that out when she stuck you with a needle full of drugs? Done all right by oldest brouhaha. It wasn't so long ago that you and me met in this very park. Me crawling out of the gutter. You looking down from on high.
Take a gander at us now, eh? Night and day.
You'd hardly recognize us, would you?
I always treated you with respect, Oz.
Respect? Oh, don't make me laugh. You only learned the word after I tossed you out of your company. Batman!
Nope.
Damn it. Where the hell is he? Usually so bloody prompt.
Unless...
this wouldn't be some kind of plan, would it? You working with the Bat? Did you really come here all alone, Bruce? If anyone could afford to keep that brute on the payroll, it's you.
Why, Oz? Are you scared of Batman?
Might be, if I weren't so certain of my upper hand, as it were. Not that you can't look after yourself. You certainly do know how to beat down an unarmed bat.
I mean, the drug only reveals your true feelings.
Felt like you were working out some issues there, eh, Bruce?
That was the drug, and nothing more.
We both know that isn't true. Your father locked my mum in Arkham Asylum to steal a fortune. He drove my own dad to suicide! Wayne's caused the ruin of my entire bloody family. Enough of this! You try to get me all shaken up? I'm not waiting any longer. Batman, be damned. We don't chat, no friend. I'm releasing these drones. They'll make mutton out of you and all the lawmen around this park. And then on to the rest of this bloody city.
All right, fine. It's my fault, Oz.
What now?
You're right. Everything that happened, everything you've gone through, that blame falls on me. On my whole family.
How unlike you to admit your faults. Maybe you think that'll save you, eh? Ah, but guess what? It won't.
Oh, yes, it will. GG. Well done.
You bloody pigs! How's this for an answer?
What a loser.
Is that all you got? I didn't see a thing. Freedom is right. I gotta admit, you surprised me. You were right about this one. Gotham owes you a debt. The GCPD does too. I won't forget it. Thank you.
Let's settle for a beer.
Yeah, I think we can make that happen.
You think this changes anything, do you? Lady Arkham's gonna have your heads served up on a platter.
He has a point. We just took down Lady Arkham's top man. She's not gonna stand for this.
No, she isn't.
Never thought I'd say this, but I hope to God that Batman has a better idea where she is than we do.
Oh, man.
How go the repairs? Going offline kept Penguin from finding the Batcave, but it also scrambled our system. The Bat computer barely runs, and worse, most of my tech isn't working. It's going to take time to get everything up and running again. If it gets running again, it's going to make tracking down Lady Arkham a hell of a lot harder.
You've proven that you don't need armor or gadgets to help this city. In the end, Bruce Wayne was the one to stop Penguin. Bruce, these last few weeks, I worry about the toll they've taken on you. Facing off against Harvey and Oswald in a matter of days. Not just the physical toll. Those were men you once trusted. And after finding out what you did about your father, people must seem a great disappointment to you. Always letting you down, even those whom you admire.
Not everyone is like my father or Oswald. And what Harvey became, it wasn't by choice.
And me. Everything that happened, I could have stopped it if I'd done something all those years ago. This is my fault. All of it. I told you I wanted to leave your father's employ. But if only I had the guts to do something instead. Your mother,
She wanted that. Wanted to put an end to his crimes. If I'd helped her... If I'd stopped Thomas, none of these horrors would have occurred. Lady Arkham, Oswald, even Harvey.
I don't blame you for what happened, Alfred. You did the best you could in an impossible situation. And it helped to make me the man I am today.
I... Thank you, Bruce.
But our work isn't done. The children of Arkham are still out there, and Lady Arkham.
With both Penguin and Mayor Dent off the board, she's the only remaining piece.
We need to figure out her next move. The only thing we do know is that she moved on from her plan to poison the city. With Penguin gone and my CEO access restored, I can finally log into Wayne Enterprises and see exactly what Oswald was doing during his time in charge. If I cross-reference that with all the data we have on Vicky Vale, we might be able to figure out the Children of Arkham's next move. Vicky Vale, mid-30s, reporter for the Gotham Gazette, and not in the public record, her true name, Victoria Arkham.
To think she was here, in the manor. She gave nothing away of her true nature then.
The Gazette's records of the articles written by Vicky Vale. This record isn't complete.
You're right. There are notable gaps between entries. But yet, it doesn't seem she ever left the Gazette's employ. So what was she doing in that time?
This record wouldn't be easy to alter. Seeing what Oswald was up to could give us a fresh perspective. The Children of Arkham. Their symbol dates back much farther than their terrorist activity. They formed to get justice for those wronged at Arkham Asylum. But the message fell on deaf ears. Until they found a leader Gotham couldn't ignore. Vicky embraced this identity to follow through on her twisted crusade.
Her mask inspires fear. Not unlike Batman.
I just need to find her.
All right. As I said, I already know about all this stuff, so I'm just going to let it play. I'm not really going to talk over it that much.
Damn it. Still offline. I need to get this working again.
Just so you guys are aware of that,
your,
you know.
Administrative access to Wayne Enterprises should have been reinstated by now, along with your title of CEO.
Let's see what Oswald was doing while he sat in my chair.
Master Cobblepot's sense of humor hasn't changed much since you were boys.
Can we just see what he was doing? Oswald altered several public records using the Wayne Network.
All mention of her birth name, Victoria Arkham, is completely gone.
Wait, what's this? He also erased something from Vicky's research at the Gazette. I can't tell what was removed from here, but Wayne Tech leaves a trace when it alters data. One the Bat Computer can decode.
What is it Miss Vale wanted to hide?
No surprise here, Oswald wiped away any trace of his criminal records. His background is completely fabricated.
He was enrolled at Cambridge? Ridiculous.
Calm down, Alfred. I'm sure the board realizes by now that they were fooled. Oswald manipulated my records as well.
It would appear your degree was in sociology.
And my medical records.
There are some, well, but colorful diseases.
Annoying, but not hard to fix.
That's better.
Oh, whoops. My bad.
Oh, Oswald certainly wasn't very frugal with my money.
You have a few yachts to return, it appears.
Also explains how the Children of Arkham had a seemingly endless supply of guns. Oswald was using Wayne money to arm them. Oswald was trying to buy an island.
What on earth for?
Looks like he was using his new legal control of Carmine Falcone's assets and likeness to brand the place. It's some kind of tourist attraction.
He was going to call it
Falcone Island.
His name isn't Falcone, it's Falcone.
Just saying. We need to figure out Lady Arkham's next move.
Of course.
Penguin was tapping into surveillance systems across Gotham. Any building using Wayne Tech security could be spied on from the CEO's office.
How is that any different than the back door into the Wayne network that he uncovered?
It's not. Unless... Hold on. What do we have here? They did more than just look at these schematics. Every building in Gotham with a Wayne Tech security system can be accessed from here and remotely controlled. If Oswald was the brawn, Vicky is the brains. So let's check her file. She may have left clues about what she was using Oswald's access for. Now that we know how Oswald manipulated Vicky's records, the back computer should be able to... There. No more holes. She was looking into Arkham patients. Reviewing records, checking submissions, prior histories. She was trying to figure out who was actually sick and who was committed because of Hill, Falcone, and my father. Vicky was digging deep. Gotham City records, freedom of information requests, posts to conspiracy forums. All to find...
It's a list. Gotham buildings that use Wayne Tech security systems.
It's a list of targets.
City Hall, Arkham Asylum, GCPD headquarters, Gotham First National. It's almost every landmark in the city.
We're onto something. Vicky wants to bypass the security at a Gotham landmark. But without a man inside Wayne Enterprises, she can't unlock that door remotely. She'll have to get her hands dirty. And when she does, we'll find her.
Bruce, you there? It's urgent. One of the bat prototypes has been stolen.
By Lady Arkham?
Not quite. I'm patching you the feed now.
She stole from you? After we opened our doors to her? After all that you two...
Alfred.
Yeah, I know, Bruce, but... Why would she do this? Is she that cold-hearted? That selfish?
She must have her reasons.
Well, I'm sure she does.
The device she stole, it's a prototype. It's an electronic skeleton key. With it, you could bypass any security system made by Wayne Tech.
That key is far too dangerous in Miss Kyle's hands, especially with Lady Arkham still at large.
Get the car ready, Alfred. I'm going to get some answers from Selina.
Getting back the key. Hell yeah. Like a boss. Again, sorry if I don't talk too much. It's just if I talk too much over this, I'll probably just sound annoyed. So, I don't want to sound annoyed at all, so... Obviously, I waited 2 weeks to play this. At least, again, so...
Damn it. Hey, Bruce. I wasn't expecting you. Thought I'd make it outside the city limits, at least. Clearly, my ride needs a tune-up.
You should know by now not to underestimate me.
I thought you might be busy with, I don't know, saving the world. I'm flattered I rank so highly. But I know you're not here for me, are you? I don't blame you for wanting it back. I'm surprised you had a toy like this. No doubt Batman would use it for the good of Gotham, but the less noble options are so much more exciting. Why should I give it back? So much potential. Just imagine what I'd be able to dig my claws into.
That device is far too dangerous to be out in the world. If Lady Arkham got a hold of it, that blood would be on your hands.
Wow. That's pretty dramatic, Bruce. Catch. You might be exaggerating, but I'd rather not take the chance. Oh, come on. Don't pretend you're not impressed. As long cons go, this one was a beauty. Getting into Wayne Tech's lab took a lot more than cracking a safe. I had to get close to people. Your friend Harvey. Poor guy just wanted to fall in love so bad. After that, it didn't take very long to get my introduction to his BFF. The great Bruce Wayne. Imagine my surprise when the rich playboy turned out to be Batman, scourge of Gotham. I was always going to steal from Bruce Wayne. I just never expected he'd be so interesting.
You talk a good game, but I don't buy it for a second. You're not that shallow.
You really think you know me that well?
I know that whatever this started as, that's not all it means to you now.
The only thing it means is that I'm very good at my job. I'm getting out of here while the getting's good. Gotham's a house on fire, and I'm not gonna burn with it. If you were smart, you'd get out of here too. This town hates you, hates your entire family. Just leave it all behind. Do something more meaningful with those skills of yours. You don't need the money, but think of the fun.
Someday, yeah. Maybe I will be able to leave Gotham. But for now, I am the only one who can save this city.
So humble. It'll be good to put some distance between us. After all, look at what happened to Harvey. It'd only be a matter of time before I crossed one of your lines. Isn't that right? My copy of the Boy Scout Handbook is out of date. I'm bound to break some rule.
Selina, I would never hurt you.
Bruce, that's really sweet. But it brings us to the root of our problem, doesn't it? You're upset that I'm leaving. What'd you think? That one night of sex meant we were going steady? Is that what you really thought?
I had fun, Selina. Didn't you?
I'm all for fun, Bruce. But how long does this stay fun before you start wanting more? Look, Bruce, I'll admit that what you and I had, it wasn't terrible. But you were just another job. A more intriguing job than I was expecting. But still a job. And that job's done. I'm done with you. It's not complicated. I'm not a good person. I'm certainly no hero.
She's making it more complicated than it really is.
I'm a thief.
That's while lying to herself.
I told you that from the start. I never pretended to be anything else.
Stop. That's not true. I know there's more to you than that. You're just afraid to admit it.
You'd like it if that were true, wouldn't you? Why would you even think that? I've made my feelings pretty clear. Why aren't you listening?
You saved my life. You could have left me to die back in that warehouse, but you didn't. Someone who's only out for herself, who's just a thief, wouldn't do that.
Oh yeah? Who would?
A good person. That's who. A hero.
You know, after I found out you were Batman, I thought nothing else could surprise me. But You just keep on surprising me.
Something to remember me by.
I won't need any help remembering you. Well, it's been fun.
You stay out of trouble, because if I catch you taking what's not yours again, I'll have to stop you.
I look forward to our next dance.
The Batman way.
Lucius, I've got the key. Hold on, Alfred's on the line. Hey, Alfred, I...
Bruce! Lady Arkham! She's here! I tried to keep them out, but...
Alfred? Alfred!
Alfred!
Here we go.
Lucius, it's Bruce. He's not here. Damn it. I'm going to search for clues.
Just tell me how I can help.
Get over here as fast as you can.
I'm on my way. We're gonna find him, Bruce.
I know. Need to focus. Figure out what happened here. What happened to you, Al? A scuff mark. What could have caused this? Furniture scattered outwards from a single point. What did they do to you, Alfred? Ash everywhere. I don't see a connection here.
But there is one, Bruce. Just don't see it. Obviously, it's this one.
Alfred grabbed the fireplace poker to fend off an attacker. But it was knocked away.
Except it wasn't a fucking dude. It was Lady Arkham. This
pool cue was used as a weapon. Swung so hard it broke in half. Blood pattern looks like it came off a high velocity hit. Alfred used the pool cue as a weapon, broke it across his attacker's head. When that didn't stop him, he used the jagged end to stab him, spraying blood across the pool table. Face was knocked over in the struggle. The fight left nothing untouched. Something big was thrown against this wall. Or someone.
Okay, it's over here. Come on.
Lady Arkham must have used the concussion blast from her staff to try and stop Alfred. I know what happened.
the children of Arkham broke in. Alfred barricaded himself inside the parlor. He had just enough time to grab a pool cue as a weapon before Lady Arkham blasted the doors open. He broke it across one of their heads, then stabbed him to get away. Another assailant tackled Alfred, knocking over the vase. Alfred almost escaped, but then Lady Arkham entered the parlor. Used her staff's concussion blast, scattering all the furniture in her path, throwing him against the wall by the fireplace. So Alfred grabs the nearest thing to use as a weapon to defend himself. But Lady Arkham deflected Alfred's attack, causing the poker to fly across the room and lodge into the wall. More blood on the mantle. He smashed his face into it. Wait. That picture doesn't belong there. Lady Arkham wanted me to find this.
So the IP address on that paper there gives Bruce Wayne access to a live feed. So
we have to keep a cool head, Lucius.
Just so you don't get confused, as I was in the second or the first time I saw this.
You're right. Let's get started.
So you need like a password to be able to see it.
Adjusting his glasses. The reflection. He's making sure I see the reflection in his glasses. He knows the Bat computer can use multiple reflection angles to recreate the room that he's in. And I can view the virtual image using my cowl.
Good thinking, Alfred.
Also glitched there. I don't know if you guys noticed, but her staff went through his body. I don't know why the fuck that was. Okay, that was not around the first time.
Freeze frame on the first signal Alfred gives.
Paint us a picture. Here we go.
Stairs leading up, cement walls. We're in a basement. Alfred's trying to look at things that might give us a clue to where he's being held. Professional grade camera. Probably came from the Gazette's office. He's wounded.
Must be one of the thugs Alfred fought upstairs.
Okay, looks like we've seen all there is to see in this frame. Let's move on to Alfred's next signal.
You got it.
Rogers Plumbing. A service company for the water heater. I can use their records to find home addresses for their clients.
We're getting closer.
Yeah, but we're not there yet. Doesn't seem to be anything else here.
Let's keep looking.
Nothing else to see here.
Moving on.
A Mason stamp.
Only one Masonic lodge in the city. Gotham City Fraternal Order of Stonemasons.
So the house was built in 1945 by them. That's a big lead. Lady Arkham. Keep searching. Jump to Alfred's next signal.
Sorry. Really shouldn't be recording when I got a throat like this, man.
A baseball window.
What's that outside?
Give me a second. They're by a bus stop.
There we go.
Okay, I think we have enough to pinpoint a location.
Well, let's hope.
The same bus stop as in The Walking Dead. It's kind of hilarious. I know it's like a New York thing, whatever, but...
bus line from this, but no stop number.
Oh, American bus stop thing. The neighborhood. Not New York.
Okay, filtering for all homes built on that date. These are all the homes serviced by this water heater company on the days and months listed. You are not going to believe this.
What is it?
Lady Arkham is back at the Vale House, where she killed her foster parents. According to its records, it has a basement. We know where Alfred is, but I'm without a working batsuit.
Actually.
One of the early prototypes.
It has basic cowl functionality, but outside of that, it doesn't protect much more than your identity, I'm afraid.
Good call. Thank you, Lucius.
It doesn't have all the bells and whistles, but it should still scare the crap out of criminals.
This ends tonight. Heading into the basement.
Be careful. Batman!
I'm all right. There's no one here. No Alfred.
Damn it!
There's blood on the walls. I'm going to see what I can find.
Standing by.
This is probably the most disturbing part of the entire fucking episode.
There's a boot print in the blood. Lady Arkham's soldiers dragged him. The trail stops at the wall. Actually, it goes under it.
Sounds like there's more to this basement than it would appear.
Taking a closer look. Now let's find out where the Vales were hiding. There's a small room. With a hole in the floor.
See what I mean? Pretty disturbing.
A rope ladder.
Anyone down there would be trapped.
Going inside.
And this is why she became bloody fucking insane.
Bruce, what's down there? Do you see Alfred?
No. Some kind of torture chamber. Shackles, belts, blood.
What?
Vicky. She was kept down here, locked away.
Who could do that to their child?
I'm beginning to understand.
What is there to understand? To willfully hurt a child?
No wonder Vicky is consumed with hate. It's all she's ever known.
I can't even imagine, but it doesn't give her the right to take it out on others.
The Vale's foster children may not have been the only ones to suffer here. I followed Alfred's blood into this hole. If he had any opportunity at all, he would have left me a clue. Alfred's glasses. Disturbing. created her here, in this room. This is where Vicky Vale became Lady Arkham. This blood is fresher than the rest. Must be Alfred's. The belt. It's caked in blood. There are drawings. Vicky must have drawn them when she was a prisoner. The chalk here is different, newer. Bloody scratches, fingernails. Someone tried to climb out.
Alfred?
No. Shackles. Blood on them. Old. And new. Vicky did to Alfred what was done to her. One piece apart from the others. Blue. The same color as my tack. Can't be a coincidence. Maybe. Figures fleeing from something. Is that Arkham Asylum? Some of the words have been highlighted. She will liberate.
She will liberate Arkham Asylum. Should be pretty obvious.
Alfred left me another clue. This is what he wanted me to find. To see. The newest chalk. He's added to an old drawing of Arkham Asylum. He drew figures outside the gates. Like they're running away. The words highlighted are, she will and liberate.
She will liberate. I don't see what that has to do with Alfred.
Alfred's just along for the ride. She's been using Wayne Enterprises to get access to the buildings with Wayne Tech security systems, including Arkham Asylum. She's going to open the doors, release the inmates, and she took Alfred with her. Call Gordon in the GCPD.
I'm on it.
Lady Arkham won't be expecting us. We'll catch her by surprise.
Orderlies are rounded up.
That's the last of it, then.
The children of Arkham have taken over.
Lieutenant Gordon says the GCPD are on their way. He's leading the team himself. If you can find Alfred, maybe you can get him out of there before all hell breaks loose.
Almost ready. Let her know.
Copy. On our way. Go ahead. I got this.
This ends now, Vicky. Tell me where Alfred Pennyworth is.
The butler. Bruce Wayne has a bat on his payroll.
Answer the question.
Where he is doesn't matter. He'll be dead soon. Another corpse in Bruce Wayne's family.
He's done nothing to you. He's not part of this.
Of course he's a part of this. He's the one man Bruce Wayne might actually care about, besides himself. His suffering will teach Wayne a lesson, one he and all of Gotham needs to learn. They won't look the other way. not again.
And when did Gotham look away from you, Vicky?
Don't try to psychoanalyze me, Batman. You have no idea what I've done to come this far. Too much to turn back now.
I've been to your home. I've seen where the Vale's kept you. People like them, they deserve to be behind bars.
Behind bars? They deserved and got far worse than that.
Even if they did, no one else needs to die.
You're wrong! Your time's run out!
Coward.
Vicky!
There's nothing you can do, Batman. You underestimate the true children of Arkham. These souls kept behind bars. Open the doors! Arkham! Listen to me! Freedom is yours! The only one standing in your way is Batman.
Batman.
He stuck me in here!
Me too. Let me out.
He's the crazy one!
Hey, Harvey, how are you doing? Sorry about the noise in the background, if you guys can hear it. Joker was right there. I don't know if you guys noticed. Get the fuck out of here. That would be like a massive head trauma right there. Especially to that.
You are going to die!
Shit. Hey, Joker. How you doing?
Inspiring. Such a pleasure to see your work in person.
Jesus.
Oh, man.
Gordon's here.
We'll round up the rest of the inmates. You stop Lady Arkham.
There's no way out now.
There's always another way here, Batman. All the people that Thomas Wayne condemned to this place unwillingly, they speak through the walls. Their ghosts walk. They know the way.
I can't help those people now, but I can help Alfred Pennyworth. Take me to him.
My pleasure.
Like a damn fucking ghost here, I don't even know why.
Vicky!
Just because there had to be a tomb underneath.
You're not well, Vicky. You need professional help.
Says the man dressed as a bat.
Let him go!
The butler has to die. Payment for Thomas Wayne's sins. He took away my family, so I'll take away his sons. If you really want to save the butler, bring me Bruce Wayne. If anyone can find him, it's you. He's probably cowering behind a 12-inch thick wall and 100 bodyguards right now.
I'll bring you Wayne. But first, let Alfred Pennyworth go.
No. Afraid he's too useful to do that just yet. You're doing so much for one old man.
Vicky, stop playing games.
This isn't a game to me.
Yes, it
you
is.
You know, Batman, I really don't understand. Why are you fighting me? I've done great things for Gotham. Falcone and Hill deserved to die. If anything, I did you a favor. We're fighting the same fight, Batman. Can't you see that? We want the same things.
We are nothing alike, Vicky. I fight to save lives. You're a cold-blooded killer.
You shouldn't be here. You shouldn't be defending him. You think Bruce Wayne is any better than Swan? He hides behind his status and wealth. He's a coward. Blaming other...
It's kind of stupid having traps killing the conversation.
Curious, Batman. I know why I wear the mask. It's who I am, who I was always meant to be. What about you? Do you wear the mask to hide, or to become who you really are? Are you the man, or the mask?
The mask is a symbol. Some fear it. But for others, it brings hope.
When I first saw it, I found it inspiring. And once you're dead, I'm going to mount that mask on my wall. But first, I'll see the man beneath.
Hmm. So I've seen both endings. So I chose one ending, which I'm gonna explain in a minute. The first time, and then the other, the second time. So.
Hold on, Alfred.
You came. You came for me. After what you said, I knew you'd come. The man I made you.
Just hold on, Alfred. Did you see where she went?
She just disappeared.
I'm getting you out of here.
Above you!
Interesting how you speak to him. So familiar, Alfred. Such concern for someone you've never met before.
It's called compassion, Vicky. Something you seem to know very little about.
Sounds like deflection to me. There's more here than you're telling. It makes me wonder, do you really care? Only one way to find out. Oh.
Batman, don't you...
Shut up, old man! You've seen my true self. Your turn. Prove that you can. Take off your mask.
So the first...
Let me see the man you really
are. The first time I took off the mask, I'm gonna attack him this time.
You're
attack
only Vicky. A piece in the bigger game, but you're the only piece I have left.
And I know that would happen, by the way. Just there's something that happens once you take off the mask that I just don't agree on, so. It just seems so fucking weird.
No more lies, no more talk. The only truth left is in your death.
And the thing that happens is that the part of your ear gets like blown out. It's kind of fucking weird. So I'm gonna not do that. His eye will be damaged after this. But, that's about it. Alfred's eye, that is. Don't know if it can heal or whatever for a possible season 2, but other people will notice that the ear is damaged after the fight on Bruce Wayne. If you show up for Bruce Wayne at the very end here, to like a press conference thing. So, if you choose to show up as Bruce Wayne, that is. But I'm sure if there's a season 2 and you're missing part of the ear, then that's gonna play a huge part in the next season. So. It's gonna be a problem.
Stop, Vicky. It's over.
Nothing will keep me from my revenge.
Thing can fail, to be honest, because sometimes I hit the wrong buttons, but it doesn't really say or anything like that.
You and the puppet.
yeah, I apologize for spoiling a little bit of stuff, but this has been out for quite a while, so. You see, he's still looking with his eyes. It's not like it's gone or anything, it's just think he's like temporarily damaged or something.
This is how it was meant to be.
If it was broken completely, he would have his eyes closed. There she goes. That would happen regardless. So even if you took off the mask, she would die anyway, but you would just have a damaged ear, and like a part of your ear would be gone, and it looks ridiculous on Bruce Wayne, so that's why I chose this ending. The first time that I tried to play this game,
a spokesperson for the GCPD assured us that the breakout has been contained and all inmates
an audio
have
issue,
returned to their
so
cells.
I couldn't hear myself in
Miss
recording.
Miss Bale is missing and presumed dead following a gruesome battle with the caped vigilante known only as the Batman. Her death marks the end of Children of Arkham's reign of terror.
And the second time, obviously, it happened to save my actions when I tried to replay it. So
this came in the mail. It's unsigned.
Selina.
Alfred, here. Let me help.
No, don't. With everything that's been going on, I haven't yet thanked you, Bruce. You've saved my life. I've no doubt Miss Vale would have killed me had you not arrived when you did. But the fact remains, in my state, I'm not of much use to you. It'll take time to adjust, and I'm afraid it may interfere with my butler duties.
Without you, none of this would work. You are my family.
You don't know how good it is to hear you say that, after everything that's happened.
I promise you, I will use everything at my disposal to help you.
Oh.
Well, sure. I mean, the silver's not going to polish itself, is it?
We will get through this, Bruce. Don't lose sight of the fact that you've done some real good for Gotham. You should be proud.
I didn't take them down alone. I had help. You, Lucius, Gordon, Selina, and all those who gave their life fighting for Gotham.
To those who helped, and those we lost.
The damage done by the Children of Arkham has left Gotham a city in turmoil. Faith in those at the top has perhaps irrevocably been shaken. Acting Commissioner James Gordon has promised to speak out about the issue tonight during an emergency citywide address.
And I hope, despite the recent terror that's gripped our city, that Gotham's leading citizens will come out to show their support.
Will his token appointment be enough to regain the city's trust? It remains to be seen. But experts agree that
Gordon requested Gotham's leaders to stand behind him. Leaders like you. Let Gotham see who Bruce Wayne truly is, and let them know what you plan to do for his future.
Well, this could be a first start.
For you, and for this city. Though, in Gotham, the only figure that can make as much impact as a Wayne
is Batman.
You've helped this city tremendously, both as Bruce Wayne and Batman. And that person, whether he dons a cape or not, is someone I'm proud of and honored to call my friend.
Thank you, Alfred.
It's always like an audio issue sometimes where it only plays in the left side for some reason.
Well, Lucius has yet to invent a suit that'll let Bruce Wayne and Batman be in the same place at once.
That is unfortunate. I suppose you must decide whose appearance will be more valuable. As Bruce, you can help repair the damage done to your name, get the public support so that you can change things from the top down. But Batman is a symbol of justice and strength. Maybe in these dark times, that is truly what Gotham needs the most.
So I chose to go as Batman the first time.
Perhaps one is truly the mask, and one is who you truly believe you are.
So I'm gonna go as Batman again just because I chose to do that. And I've seen what happens when you go as Bruce, so I'll go as Batman.
Batman will be in attendance.
You'll make quite the impression. Gordon will be grateful.
We're currently awaiting newly appointed Acting Police Commissioner James Gordon, who will address the city for the first time in the wake of the terrorist attacks perpetrated by Lady Arkham.
I, as Acting Police Commissioner... Commissioner Gordon. That doesn't sound right. Batman! Is everything all right? I assume you're not here to give a speech. So, what is it?
I wanted to show Gotham that I stand with its new commissioner.
Acting commissioner. But all the same, I appreciate it. City's on edge. Tonight can make all the difference. You're one hell of an addition to this lineup. Gotham's best and brightest have turned out for this. I know you're not a man of many words, but I'd like to say something to Gotham on your behalf. Is there anything you'd like them to know? Maybe about how you'd like to be seen moving forward?
Tell them I'll work alongside you and the GCPD to protect Gotham. The criminals of this city will stand no chance against us.
Now that they won't. You know, I always wanted this. To be commissioner someday. To have the chance to shape this. I should probably be used to that by now.
Every time.
Now, in the last few weeks, as much violence and terror as I've seen, I've also seen the citizens of this community band together to fight those threats. One of those citizens is Batman. He'll work alongside the GCPD to lift Gotham out of these dark times. But I'm not only asking Batman and my officers to be heroes. I'm asking all of you, too. Let Gotham be a city of heroes. United, strong, and hopeful.
Man.
Clear the area. Get that bastard to lock up.
Just minutes ago, Acting Commissioner James Gordon delivered a rousing speech that turned into a shocking assassination attempt on his life. Batman made short work of the assassin.
Oh boy, it's gonna be tough to top that.
But I'll give it a shot.
That, ladies and gentlemen, was the Joker. Yet again. So yeah, that lines up for a season 2, obviously, and this was the last episode, so. Apparently I can't see the choices for some reason, don't know why. Doesn't really matter. So that's that. So thanks for watching, guys, and don't forget to hit the like button and the subscribe button, and I'll be back again in the future. And yeah, that'll be that. So yeah, happy new year, I should say, I guess. And I'll see you next time. Once again, stay awesome.